Juan, what the hell do you got me out doing here, man?
I know. This is like, the things we do for the podcast.
Oh, shit, dude. Hi, and welcome to another episode of the Juan Awards podcast. My name is Angelica Casares.
And I'm Juan Alanis. Thank you for joining us.
Welcome. Welcome in our new, ay Dios, our new adventure. This one's going to be short and sweet because...
it's a little scary here.
We're on a pretty big incline here.
Yeah, we're on an incline, but we're hoping that the view that you're getting from this vantage point is pretty good.
It's beautiful out here. So we're in New Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
Even the stupid tripod is like leaning.
I know.
I gotta take a picture of that. Yeah, I do. Go ahead, Juan. Go ahead. Go ahead.
No, so the last time we checked in on the on our last episode, we were in Utah. We were in a hurricane. Hurricane.
Correct.
I think they called it, instead of hurricane, it's spelled hurricane, but I think they call it hurricane. But hurricane Utah. And we since have left. We made our way through Albuquerque, and we are on our way in New Mexico. And we were on the way home. We said, you know what? Let's stop at this Sandia Mountain range that we heard about. And so that's where we are now. We're like sitting on top of the Sandia Mountain crest near like their little ski resort area. And we found this little trail.
Beautiful trail.
In the middle of nowhere.
It's a beautiful trail.
And it's very quiet, very peaceful.
I'm sure it's not in the middle of the nowhere. I'm sure the people around here know where it's at.
Yeah. Well, to us, you know.
It's in the middle of nowhere to us.
And so we said, Helica was like, you know what? Let's record up here. And we said, okay, let's do it. But we are on a pretty steep incline. So like these little shrubs right here.
They're probably going to be the ones that are holding us.
So forewarning, if you see us go rolling.
It's not a far, because there's like a small cliff right here next to us.
Yeah.
But it won't be. So you'll just probably see our legs flying. It'll be entertainment for sure.
Yeah. But no, I think we just wanted to come in and I think the last.
Check in with you.
What?
What?
Right now your foot moved and I thought that was like a little squirrel or something running through. And I was like, what the? I was like, wait, there's like a squirrel next to you.
Okay, you can tell we're not like nature people. Like, this is not something we do regularly.
Yeah.
And so, first of all, this is fun. Two, we are very self-aware as to like what's going on. Okay, so I have a confession. I have a really hard time. I don't, I'm not a nature walking person. And so I am a very conscious person that I have to be near a restroom all the time.
Oh, yeah.
I have to confess, I don't know how to pee. I don't know how to pee out like in nature. I don't. And this is like the second time I end up peeing on like my socks or shoes. Because I don't know what I'm doing. Like, what am I doing wrong? If somebody knows, please let me know. Point me in the right direction. Like, is there a blog post? A video I should be watching? Because I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing.
There may be a guide out there.
They can tell me. Yeah, like women hikers, how do you do this? I know how to like pee, like I know how to pee, like air pee, like over, like hover over a toilet.
Mm.
But I don't know what I'm doing when I'm out here in the wilderness.
Yeah. Well, you gotta aim.
How do you aim? How am I supposed to aim? I'll leave that there. Okay, so anyway.
We'll stop there.
Yeah, we'll stop there. Anyway, so we're here in New Mexico. We made, like Juan said, we made our way this way. This is our first time out here, like out in these crevices, so far up north in, especially New Mexico and Arizona and things like that. I think the farthest we've ever been, like north of these like southern states, for me perhaps, is the Grand Canyon.
Mm-hmm.
That was it.
So... I guess I have a question for you. So I guess since we're like on the topic of travel, like when, mm-hmm. from the first time that we started taking road trips to now, like what do you feel, how do you feel? Do you think it's different? Do you feel like we are more prepared, or do you feel like, how do you feel like, I guess you, like, how do you feel about from then to now? Cause it's been a few years since we started actually doing road trips.
I think for sure we still don't know how to pack. For whatever reason, we like to pack everything.
Yeah, we pack way too much.
We do. And this time was significantly, like, way too much.
Yeah. Well, I think because, like, for me, like, normally when we go somewhere, I think, like, oh, okay, like, if I'm going to have meetings, let me take a blazer, let me take some dress clothes.
Let me take a shirt.
And let me take some shirts. Like,
you see, we can do that, but we overpack. We, like, have, like, 3-5 outfits. Like,
but this time I didn't have any meetings. I didn't have any meetings.
So why did you bring shirts?
I was like, so why did I pack all of that stuff? Like, I packed my dress shoes and everything. And I was like, why did I do all that? Like, I'm like, I can see, like, I was like, well, I guess I was thinking, like, maybe if, you know, there's an evening, there's, like, an evening event or something. Or, like, yeah. I don't know. Like, I was like, maybe there's, like, something fancy or something.
Yeah.
But I was like, it really was. It was more casual.
So for me, Juan, it was a good conference that I went to. And I overpacked for sure. I don't know. I don't even know why I packed half of the things. So I packed, like, pants and like, dress up stuff. But then I forget. At every other conference, I never dressed like that. So why did I think it was going to be different now?
Mm.
So I put on my jeans and like a nice dressy shirt and some heels. That's usually the way I dress for conferences. I think like at conferences, like I always overpack. And I don't know why I do that.
Yeah, like I was, like I said, I took more stuff than I needed. And then I was like, and then I like, I packed, I think I counted the days. I was like,
yeah.
I was like, okay.
We packed for like half a month.
I was like 10 days. And so I packed for every single day.
Yeah, no, but we packed like if we were going to, our sleeping clothes, our day clothes, and then our working clothes.
Yeah.
So we packed like we were packing for a full on, like a whole half month the way we do, like the way we live out of the house.
I think because the last time when we went to Arkansas, we packed a lot. We ended up using a lot more.
Yeah.
So we, like, I think I felt like we didn't pack. We packed in just enough to for what we needed. And this time, because it wasn't as busy, like, uh-huh. we didn't need as much. So we could have easily done without a lot of it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, okay. So we're having this conversation, right? And we're talking about packing. What? So you asked me, how good are we at it? What do you think?
I think the experience is just different. Like, I think when we first started traveling, and this was, like, over 10 years ago, I would say.
Uh-huh.
Like, we kind of were just going, and we didn't really prepare the way that we prepare now.
Okay.
I feel like now we prepare mm-hmm. more, like, in terms of, like, the things that we bring. Like, we're more selective about, like, you know, what things do we actually need on the road?
Yeah.
And I think like things like, you know, basic things like water, like snacks, like yeah. we try to pack a lot of that so we don't have to do a lot of stops on the road. Yeah. On the road, and we just kind of prepare that as we're leaving from wherever we're at. So,
you know, one of the things, Juan, that I do have to admit, though, instead of a whole bunch of little bags, I probably need to get two big bags.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's for sure one of the things, because we pack a lot of little bags.
Yeah.
And it gets heavy, like it gets cumbersome to like. But frolic around with everything.
But it's convenient to do little bags because mm-hmm. it's like
it is.
You can easily like switch them out, and like if you don't want to go yeah. like the last couple of stops we made, we haven't gotten everything off, because you know, when you get everything off, the thing is we have an Subaru Outback, and so like we pack that thing, the entire back seat, the yeah. entire back hatch of it,
yeah,
it's all packed, everything is full in there, so everything, like there's really literally no room in there,
yeah.
For anybody. Like yeah. before, when Edgar would travel with us, we would leave just enough room for him to sit.
Okay, so then now I have to admit, Juan is actually packing a screen for work.
Yeah, yeah.
We need to find something more compatible, like something more compact.
Yeah.
Something that can fold easily and like go into like a bag or something.
Because
that one I fear we're going to break eventually.
No, but the thing is, like, if it wasn't an expensive screen, so I'm like, it's fine if it like... You mm-hmm. know, if I need to replace it, like, I think it's fine.
Yeah, but still, it's still big, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And the size doesn't matter. It's the way it doesn't fold away.
Yeah, and I think,
yeah.
other than preparations, I think the other thing is, like, we're more intentional about, like, kind of in being in the moment. Like,
yeah.
When we're traveling, like,
yeah.
to like, look for things to do
yeah.
that we're going to both enjoy.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
I feel like before we kind of just were like, oh, look, there's something there. And we like rush over there and like, oh, look, there's a sign that says like there's a park here. And we just run over there. And
yeah.
Now
yeah.
we kind of plan it out. Like we spend time beforehand, like seeing like, okay, what cities do we want to stop in? And then, you know, if we can, then we try to book the
yeah.
either the hotels or the Airbnb. Hey, thanks for listening to this episode. We hope you're enjoying it. And this is Giving November for us. We decided that for the month of November, we wanted to reach out to people that were out there online who we were
our fellow entrepreneurs.
Fellow entrepreneurs. And we said, hey, you know what? We want to pay it forward. We want to give back this holiday season. So why don't y'all, if you want us to mention your brand, your company on our podcast, let us know and we'll be happy to do that. And we had a few folks reach out. So
yeah.
today, our sponsors are actually some of our fellow entrepreneurs who reached out
our
to
friends,
us.
Our fellow entrepreneurs, yeah. our people out there hustling.
Yeah.
We appreciate you. You give us the motivation, and we want to motivate you also. So mm-hmm. if you're interested in highlighting your business and becoming part of our sponsors, this is free. This is free to you, and it's a pleasure for us. So if you would like to be included in this, please let us know. Send Juan an email at juanawards.com.
Right, or reach out to me on Instagram.
Yeah.
So our first sponsor is one that we actually have their products right here in the studio.
We did.
It's Mezcal for Life. Uh-huh. So mezcal as in the drink. If you don't know what mezcal is, you're missing out. You know? Mezcal is one of my favorite drinks. But yeah, it's Mezcal for Life, and their website is actually mezcalforlife.com. But the way they describe themselves, they say they're curious finds for mezcal and tequila lovers. So it really is like, you know, you're talking about shot glasses, you're talking about margarita glasses, you're talking about all the barware that you would need.
Correct, glassware.
Mm-hmm. Glassware, you can find it. And it's what's cool about it, what I like about it, is that it's made by artisans in Mexico. So they work with different artisans from the heart of Oaxaca to Jalisco is how they describe it on their website. But it really is artisans in Mexico making this by hand. And then they work with Mezcal for Life to get it out, to make it available wherever you are in the globe that you want to buy. So,
nice. They're beautiful blue glasses. Yeah. So, yes, check them out. If you go to their website, it's Mezcal, MEZCALIFE.com. Look at their blue glasses, the blue shot glasses.
The cobalt blue.
Cobalt blue glasses. Yes, those are the ones we have. They're beautiful.
And they have so many other things besides shot glasses. They have a lot of like different, you said glassware.
Yeah.
That's really going to be
artisan useful. Glassware. They're beautiful. Yeah. Go check them out.
Awesome. And the next one,
my friend. I'm doing this because I look, she didn't even say Angelica feature me or whatever. I'm featuring her because I love her shit. I love her store. I'm there all the time. I actually should.
I have her air freshener in my car right now.
I probably should. We should probably not be spending as much time as we go sometimes when we sit there. We can sit there for hours and looking through her stuff. So, and you're like, who are you talking about? Kismet Boutique. That's K-I-S-M-E-T. She is on Instagram. She sells, I believe, online. She has an actual boutique. She has a brick and mortar boutique. It's phenomenal. It's a very nice big space to have products from other, like, so her items she gets from, like, she sources them from different places. Mm-hmm. And then she online and offline, and people who make soap by hand and candles and buttons and balloons and clothes and like artisan stuff that comes from like Mexico. I mean, she has an array and variety of stuff. I love her stuff.
It's a lot of Mexican, Latina-owned. It's a Latina-owned business.
Yes.
That was established in 2014. Mm-hmm. And they have artisans, materials, they have apparel, they have gifts, and cultura, I think, is the big thing that they focus on.
We bought we're talking like she has art for sale on her wall. She has like keychains made from like somebody based in like California. She sources from everywhere. She has a passion for looking out for great items online, and she sources them right to you. And she's like she's a one-stop shop.
Yeah, if you're a sticker collector, I send Edgar a little Topo Chico sticker, and he was like, oh, this was pretty cool. Send me more.
That's cool, yeah. So, for example, like, say you're looking around for, like, gifts, right? But you're trying to buy them, like, in different places. Like, she's a one-stop shop.
It's definitely very unique.
Yeah, she's a one-stop shop where you can buy, like, your friend, like, a gift. And it varies from ages and everywhere. Like, even baby. She has, like, some baby items there. Yeah. But she sources them, and you can buy, like, something from one, like, artisan, and then somebody who makes stickers. And somebody who makes the balloons, you stop there, you go to her place, you buy what you need.
Yeah.
Anyway, so she has an amazing boutique. She's online also at Kismet Boutique. That's KismetBoutiqueHouston. Kismet Boutique Houston.
There you go.
Uh-huh. Online.
On Instagram.
Yeah.
For sure.
I'm all excited about this one.
No, that's a
I love
good
her.
One.
I love her. Okay.
That's awesome.
Christina. FYI, yes. Her name's Christina. Her name's not Kismet. Her name's Christina. Right. Go ahead.
And then our next sponsor for this show is actually Fabian Contreras Espinosa, who goes by Fabes Fab Life on Instagram. That's F-A-B-E-S Fab, F-A-B-L-I-F-E on Instagram. And he's a hairstylist, and he's also a model based here in Houston. Mm-hmm. And so he says he does all things hair, creative, set, stylist, visuals. I'm reading this because I don't know exactly what that means. I'm sure the woman out there in the audience, the ladies
Admin.
Out there know.
Admin.
Probably know.
Uh-huh.
And he has another Instagram account where you can follow all his hair, like the different things that he does for those services. So he has, it's Fabian and Hair.
So if you want to get to know more more of like the kind of things that he's based here in Houston. And if you want to get to know the kind of stuff, the kind of hairstyles that he can commit to and do for you, he's on there. He says he's up for consultations available. So mm-hmm. if you want to get a consultation, hit him up.
And you know how sometimes when you go to a hairdresser or a barber, you want somebody who has experience.
Yeah.
So he has 10 years behind the chair that he's been doing this. So he's seasoned. He knows what he's doing. He's gonna do you right, right? So you wanna call Fabian, and like I said,
hit him up.
It's at Fabes Fab Life, his personal, and then Fabian and Hair is his other account for his hairstyling.
Yeah, like I said, he's up for consultations. Yeah. So if you have like maybe an event we're opening back up, and there's something that you want to get done and you need a consultation, hit him up.
Yeah. Well, thank you again.
Those are our sponsors for this episode. We greatly appreciate you.
Mezcal for Life, Kismet Boutique, and Fabian Contreras Espinosa. We appreciate you guys. Thank you so much.
Awesome. And we hope you enjoy the rest of the episode.
So a young couple was walking by and they started talking to us. And we just had a conversation with them here for a few minutes. And I think that's one of the things about like travel like this is that you get to meet people that, you know, just randomly like in the moment that, you know, it's not necessarily that you're like, oh, now we're lifetime friends or anything. It's just like,
you just happen
to cross paths with people by chance. And I think that's like, I'm a little out of breath here. I don't know why.
You know what it is? It's the altitude. And we were talking.
Oh, and I was trying to like inch my way into this chair. But yeah, I mean, you get to meet people. Like
we were trying to balance and that took our breath away. It did.
No, but you get to meet people like that, cross paths with people. And I think sometimes you can like take away something from somebody. Like it doesn't take long. Like you don't have to know somebody for a very long time to like glean something or to like maybe it's like a, not a lesson, but maybe it's just like a thought that comes from the conversation.
Yeah,
you know, that in the moment. And I think like it's so like, you know, where else could you like randomly run into people?
Like up in the mountains somewhere.
Up in the mountains. Like,
you know, people who want to hike and visit the mountains are typically very nice people.
Yeah.
If you're like out here just trying to enjoy nature, you're typically a nice person. So this is, I think, anyway, to the road trip, right? It's that we like to venture into like little corners of spaces.
Yeah.
And I think we're talking about packing. And I think that's one of the things that I feel like I've gotten better at. It's like how to pack as if I'm going to take pictures every day, but how to pack like I'm going to enjoy my day.
Mm-hmm. Well, I like to pack like there's certain things that are essential that I pack that I'm like I need my warm-ups, I need my chanclas, and I need my like comfortable t-shirts.
Yeah.
Because I'm like no matter what's going on, like whether it's a bunch of networking, whether it's a bunch of meetings or whatever it is, mm-hmm. when I get back to wherever I'm staying, I like to be comfortable. So I like to get like I like to have like my comfortable clothes there. And then the other thing that I pack now that I didn't pack before at the beginning that I always forgot were like swim trunks. Or swimming clothes.
You know what? I forgot my bathing suit, and I wasn't able to get in the water.
Because sometimes you don't know whether you're going to use them or not. Mm-hmm. But if you get the chance to get into water, it's better to have them than to not.
Yeah.
And I learned that the hard way because there was times before in trips where we were traveling, and then there was like, oh look, there's a body of water, and I wanted to get in, and I was like, oh, you don't have the right clothes for it. And so like now it's like, you know, you just have it with you. So like things like that are like things that I pack that are like, oh, okay. Yeah. And then like, you know, other things that I just like, there's, I guess those are like more comfort things that from home, because wherever you are, like, I guess the way I feel about travel in a way when we're moving around from place to place is like, as long as I have certain essential items, like I feel like I have the comforts of home, you know, like I have my, you know, like Q-tips or like, you know, things like that, that I just like, you
those
know,
are your comfort from home Q-tips.
Yeah. Like after I take a shower, I like to like, I have a thing about like,
you have a routine.
I have a routine and I want to do, and I want to have my Q-tips and I want to, you know, there's certain things that I just enjoy. Like, you know, the sparkling waters, like we drink a lot of sparkling water. So like, these things are like, these are comfortable.
Yeah,
like, I
feel those like, are a comfort for us.
I feel like when I have those around, I'm like, oh, okay, it's like, I'll just grab a drink.
Yeah, like you're still bringing part of home with you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And like what I was trying to convince Angelica on this trip, I was like, we should bring Becky.
The cat, our cat. Can you imagine?
Because the place that we were staying at in Scottsdale, they actually accepted pets, which a lot of places don't accept pets. Mm-hmm. But if, for example, if you're looking for Airbnbs, like it's not always, because a lot of them don't accept pets.
Well, here's the thing with Becky is that she's not, she's a very domesticated animal, but very still wild at heart.
Yeah.
And so with her, I fear mm-hmm. that she won't do well on road trips.
Yeah, I don't think on the road itself. I think she'll struggle on the road a little bit.
We'll stress her out.
But I think when she gets somewhere, like she's good about kind of familiarizing herself with her environment, and then just kind of like, okay, like after a while, like at first she's like, you know, like I think most cats, she'll be shy and like not wanting to move around.
Yeah, for the first 12 hours, she'll be like very like coy and like, you know, very like standoffish. But the thing with her is I do want to like bring her out. I want to like leash her up. Mm. And did you hear that bird?
Yeah.
It's gorgeous out here. But anyway, I do want to leash her up, and I do want to get her used to like taking her for walks.
Yeah.
Because I do want her to enjoy spaces like this with us.
Yeah, and that's the thing. Like, you know, when we were in, in Utah, when we were at the
For
at
those
the
who don't know, Becky's our cat. Yeah. Because we didn't even say that. Becky could potentially.
Just assume that you've been listening for a while, you know our cat is named Becky. But yeah, Becky's our cat. She's a Siamese cat. Mm-hmm. And, but no, you know, it made me think about that too. It was like, because I had tried to convince you beforehand. Mm-hmm. And you were like, I don't know if she'll enjoy it. And I was like, okay. And so, but when we were in when we were in Utah, one of the state parks, I forgot, mm-hmm. Snow Canyon.
Yeah.
I think it was called Snow Canyon State Park. And there was a man there who was mm-hmm. driving around in a bike.
With his dog.
With his like little miniature dog in the back.
Yeah.
And it was cold there. So he had like a mm-hmm. like little white
blanket,
like a little white blanket in there that so that the dog wouldn't be cold.
Yeah. So
I was like, what, look at that dog. He's just like living his life, like looking around at all the red mountains everywhere. And I'm like,
yeah, I think we can strap Becky in a backpack and put her and start bringing her out to nature like that. Yeah. Instead of her being out of the bag, but her still be like enclosed in like a small space to where she still feels like comfortable. Us and then like the backpack, you know what I mean, we have it. I'm so afraid that I'm gonna stress her out.
Well, I think about it like more like, since we talk like maybe at some point we want to do longer periods of like longer road trips where we're out for longer periods of time, or we're out for like maybe a couple of weeks, a couple of months, mm-hmm. And then I'm like, well, you know, at that point you would want to kind of bring your pet with you, because you know it's a long time to leave the pet at home by itself.
Correct.
Or Becky at home by herself, mm-hmm. the pet it by itself.
Don't call her it. That's horrible.
I know. So like it's a long time to leave her by herself at home. So it's
it
like
is.
It's like I'd rather like. You know, get her starting, getting her used to, so that if we do go on a longer trip, she can go ahead and come along with us.
Yeah, I do. I want to. But, I mean, that's for the future. I mean, and I should probably start her on that. You know, start her getting her used to how to, like, the like other people, noises, lights, because she's a very scaredy cat.
Yeah.
Like, anything jolts her. Any new presence, any new smells, like, it overwhelms her.
Yeah. She doesn't like it. And I think she's just not used to it. I think it's not that she doesn't like it. I think she's just not used to it. She's not, like, she's never done it.
She's very much set in her ways, in her routine.
Yeah.
She,
Because when we brought her out,
just around. Ways in her routine. So, like, for example, when I kick her out of the room, she gets upset.
Oh, yeah.
And she starts, like, hitting the doors, both of the doors, to try to get back in. Because she's set in her way. She wants to sleep at the feet of my bed.
Yeah.
That's it. And you can't convince her any different.
Yeah.
She does not change from food or treats or snacks. She will not have anything else.
Yeah.
She is set in her ways.
But I guess in a way that's like another comfort of like home, is like having your pet around too, is like, you know, having that like, oh, okay, well, like, you know, it feels like your little environment is there, no matter like if you're staying at your house or if you're staying at an Airbnb or you're staying in a hotel or wherever you're staying. No?
Yeah. But so anyways, going back to like the packing part, there's a lot of shit that I could have left at home. I think half of my shit I could have left. Mm.
I think we would have a lot more space in the car.
Yeah. Shut up. Just me? No. That would include you. Half of your shit could have stayed also.
Well, no. I think like all the things that I bought on the hanging thing, I could have left.
Like
home.
Literally, Juan, we're riding around. Like you're just taking it for a paseo.
Yeah.
Like your clothes hanging.
Yeah. La man's paseando la ropa. But no, I think everything that I brought in those hanging things, that could have stayed home. Mm-hmm. I could have probably brought half as many like pants. I brought shorts, which I was.
You keep wearing the same pants over and over.
Yeah, there's been like two or three that I've been wearing, and that's it. And I brought shorts, but it's been cold, so I'm like, it's not really good weather for cold for shorts. And I brought like most of my shorts.
You know what? We should have checked the fucking weather.
Yeah,
that's what we should have done.
I brought most of my shorts, and I'm like, well, there's no reason to bring. I need the swim shorts. Yeah, like, 'cause
yeah, we still got a lot of learning to do.
But I think it's like more. The more you do this, the more you learn. The more that you get familiar with it. Mm-hmm. But I want to what somebody was saying. The girl that we were talking to, the couple we were talking to, she said that for people that are not that just listen, that you guys were talking about being visual. Mm-hmm. So for people that are listening. Mm-hmm. I would say, first, let's invite you to watch the video. But if you're not able to watch the video, you want to describe the place that we're sitting in?
Oh, my God, absolutely. So here we go. So beyond the backs of... Ay, Dios, I'm going to fall. Agarra la silla, Juan. So
the bad thing of grabbing the seat is that we're both going to go rolling back.
So beyond the brush of the changing flowers, the leaves on the trees and the pines, out into the distance is the mountain range. If you're familiar with mountain ranges, Google Sandia Peak Mountains. Mm. That is our backdrop. Down, there's like a small valley. And you can see like houses, tiny, tiny, tiny houses in some like open fields. But like off into the distance, this is not the stuff that you pick up. Only your eye picks up. Very difficult for cameras to pick up, or very difficult for like photography to pick up. It's like more mountain ranges, like to the far to your eye can see.
As far as your eye can see, yeah.
Yeah.
And so the leaves, the foliage here is like, there's like, it's starting, we're in October, we're in like mid-October, so it's starting to turn.
The leaves are turning.
So like we've got like
bright orange, green,
yellow, like we've got a little bit in the
dark green, yeah.
The mountain peak is covered in the pine trees, which is very nice, and it's like... There's some, like right here next to us is this long, like pine, I guess, that fell, like one of the trunks or something. Yeah. It's like a long piece that fell next to us.
Yeah.
And I mean, it's beautiful. We got the terrain up here. Climbing wasn't that bad. It is kind of rocky.
Yeah.
Here and there. Uh-huh. But it's very nice. And like the drive up, there was like some red mountain also when you were driving up, which we didn't see as much as here as we did in like Utah, but like there is a little bit of red mountain when you're driving up. Mm-hmm. And we're about 8,000
feet of elevation?
Feet above sea level. Uh-huh. So just to give you a picture, if you're not, and actually there's a tree here in front of us that is wrapped in yarn, I think, or wool.
They can't see that.
I know. That's what I'm saying. I'm describing to the people that are listening. Like, there's a tree.
It's a memorial to somebody.
A memorial to somebody.
Somebody's mom. So they wrap the tree in yarn. It looks like this might be in the spot that they would bring there, come with their mom often.
Yeah.
So they did do like a small little memorial of like a pile of rocks and then painted rocks, and then they wrap the tree in yarn.
Yeah.
And it says to mom, I love you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you get to see, like, you know, little things like that. It's like, that are like humanizing, because you don't know anything about whoever those people were that didn't build
the
memorial.
But I felt that as soon as I seen it.
But you can relate.
Yeah.
So
I can't relate, but I felt it.
Well, no, yeah. Like, I mean, from on a human level, not that you can relate, like, you know, that.
Well, it's difficult to relate if you haven't lost your mother.
Yeah.
But I've lost my sister. And so I can relate with pain and the memorial of it and the gratitude that you can see it. You know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah. I think one of the things that I did want to mention is that, you can still see the changing of like the red dirt, and like it's rocky. The mountains are rocky.
Yeah.
They're not like smooth up. Most mountains are, but these are like smaller rocks. So it's hard to explain. I don't know. I don't know how to describe it. I think it takes away your breath. But one of my favorite places, and I think I've said this before, if you want to immediately get your breath taken away with just the absolute, like, oh my God, I can't believe I'm witnessing this. Mm-hmm. I was telling them it's the Grand Canyon.
Oh yeah.
That place, there's nothing like I've ever seen, I've ever experienced when I walk into the Grand Canyon.
Yeah.
At first look, it just kisses you. It embodies you. You walk away and you, whoever, whatever, however was made, it was made with soul. It was made with just so, Earth just created it for you to experience it.
Yeah.
I don't know how to explain it. And so you get to experience it. And people have said Sedona. I don't feel like it's nice Sedona. Sedona is very beautiful. So is like Utah. So is right here in New Mexico. But the Grand Canyon, there's something about it that it just speaks to your spirit. It speaks to your soul.
Hey there. Thank you for listening. We appreciate you listening to this episode. And if you're watching us, if you're not watching us, you should. But if you're watching us, then you'll see that we're in the middle of beautiful Utah right now. And yes. We just wanted to come in and say how much we appreciate you guys listening to us and being a part of our podcast, growing podcast community that we're kind of building.
Yeah.
We've been working
on.
We're growing. That's exciting. And so, you know, we want to remind you that if you enjoy this show, you can always go to Apple Podcasts and you can leave us a rating. You can leave us a review. And the reason that we ask you to do that is because it helps us to get new listeners. It helps us to get in front of new people and for people to see that, you know, hey, there's this couple, Mexican-American couple out here doing these podcasts. And they do sometimes talk about interesting stuff, hopefully.
At least we're funny. I hope we're funny to you. At least that much. But did you know that sometimes we get listened to on Spotify?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So if you're on Spotify, I'm not very familiar. I'm not very familiar with Spotify, but if there is a way to share our stuff or to send the link that where we're at to people, not where we're at physically, but like online.
Yeah, you can share
send
our
it.
Episodes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Send our episodes, share our episodes with a friend. And I think, you know, just if you're not watching us, we also want to let you know that we do record these podcasts in video format. So you can find us, our videos online. You can find us on Facebook, on YouTube, and you can just go to our website, juanofwords.com, where you can find all the links. But we just wanted to interrupt you real quick to say thank you for listening, that we appreciate it, and that we know you're there. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Also, comment, leave, like, tag your friend. And just tell them, hey, these people are crazy. Come listen to them.
All right. Now back to the show.
Yeah. Like, anyway.
Like, I think, like you said, going to Zion, like, it was beautiful. Mm-hmm. But I didn't get the same feeling that I did when we went to the Grand Canyon.
You look at it and you're...
Same thing for Sedona. Like, I didn't... It's beautiful.
Yeah.
But I didn't... It wasn't the same feeling.
So you walk into the Grand Canyon and it's immediate. It's like...
Yeah.
It's like, I don't know how to, like, it hits you. It has an air about it. And you're like, and then, like, you'll walk away and you'll come back. And every time I come back, I want to cry because every time it's,
and there's like,
you know, it's just, I just love making that sound because that's how I feel every time I could see it. Yeah. Go ahead.
There's like a charm to it. It's like, you know, the animals, the weather, the little town outside of it. Like, everything is like, it's just so like,
that's pretty.
It feels
the
like
site
so,
itself of Sedona. It just
Sedona,
not Sedona. I'm sorry, the Grand Canyon.
The Grand Canyon.
It's so fucking majestic.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard. It's like one of those things where you just look at it and it's like, is this even real?
Yeah.
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 So highly recommend. Like, I think we're always recommending the Grand Canyon.
The Grand Canyon, because just, I don't know, it's the South Rim, the one that I'm talking about.
Yeah.
There's little spots that you can like hide away, and then you go and you look, and you're like, fuck,
you can spend,
I'm here.
You can spend a lot of time there, like really enjoying it, really taking it in, and. Just don't stand at the edge. But yeah, take it in.
Yeah.
Take it in. And like, it's beautiful pictures too. I mean, like, but it's hard. I was going to say, like, it's hard to capture like the beauty of sometimes of places like this. Mm-hmm. I think the lighting is kind of off now. We're like super dark.
It's okay. As long as you can see the back behind us, we're okay.
But I think that sometimes it's the, like, it's hard to capture in video or in pictures what, like, something, the beauty of something, of a place, of a destination. There's nothing like, no matter how much, like, we can share on social and this and that, like, there's nothing like being there yourself in person.
Yeah.
Like, there's just, like, you can't describe, like, it's hard to describe, like, even though we were trying to describe it now, it's like, I don't know if we did a good job, but, like, we're just trying to describe things, and it's, like, it's hard to explain difficult. It unless...
I think our adjectives are, it's beautiful.
Yeah. It's gorgeous. It's colorful.
It's tree. Yeah. It's a mountain.
Yeah.
Okay, well, what else? Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, but this is what, you know, we just want to, we want to do more of this, like we had said in the beginning, in the last episode. And, you know, we're kind of seeing, like, as we kind of travel, if we can find little spaces like this where we can just kind of have a little quiet area where we can record, where we're out of the way of people, and we can just kind of, you know, do our little thing, give you guys a little, a new episode where we're out in nature and hopefully give you something really beautiful to look at.
Yeah. I'm just kidding with you. Like, I was just waiting for you to see what else you're
like,
going to say.
You're like in the moment, and she's like, yeah.
Yeah. No, it's because I'm like, I'm reminiscing back to like the stop, our stops and like the things. And I, I don't know. All of a sudden, the appreciation just like swept up upon me.
Yeah,
I mean, like gratitude. I don't know what to explain. Like I'm just like listening, and like I'm looking back, and I'm like, fuck, like we're here.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's like, you know, that's just like, I don't know. It's hard to explain it, but it just like, it's nice to be able to do this.
Yeah.
And I think that for me, like one of the things is like, you know, I don't, you know, you don't know how long you'll be able to travel.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, we're old. Yeah, estamos viejitos. But we're still young enough to be able to enjoy this. Like, there was a couple that was walking in with us, and they were much older than us, and he had a cane.
Mm-hmm.
Not a cane. He looked like he had a walking stick to, like, walk with. And, like, he hit a rock, and he almost, like, stumbled over. And they stopped. Mm-hmm. And then I think, Juan, you asked him, you're like, oh, are you going to go up? And they're like, we're trying.
No, they said good luck when we walked by, and I said, "Oh, is this your first? It's like, is it a long walk?"
Mm-hmm.
And they said, "Oh, we don't know." And they said, and then I said, "Oh, okay, this is our first time too." And we walked by, and then I was like, "It was rocky coming up, so it was like a little bit of a challenge." So I was like, "I think he would have struggled to come up." So
yeah, because it's definitely up in an incline and down. He would have like fell over or something.
Yeah.
He didn't want to risk it, but I mean, they made it all of like maybe 15 feet away from their like.
And that's not to say that older people can't travel, because in Scott's.
I'm sorry. They made it all of like 50 feet away from their car until they started like hitting like the rocky part of it.
Yeah.
And they had to turn around and go back.
Yeah.
So they didn't, this right here, what we're looking at,
they weren't able to see it.
They weren't able, they're not able to see it.
And that's not what I was saying.
But that's what I'm saying. Like we're able to do this, Juan.
Yeah.
And so I just like talking to the young couple right now.
Mm-hmm.
Talking to the older couple, and then I realizing that they came over and they were also able to enjoy it, and the other couple wasn't. Like it just, like I'm just grateful. So when you were talking earlier, I was just like, it overcame me again. You know what I mean? Every time I go to the Grand Canyon, it takes me.
Mm.
And I look at here, and it takes me here. And here we are with microphones and our camera.
Yeah. And that's the thing. Like, but what I was saying is like, it's not to say that old people can't travel, because in Utah, they were like in those electric bikes riding up and down the mountain. I was like, whoa, that looks like a lot of fun.
Running is over. Talking about burn. I'm like, man, I'm moving.
But I mean, I guess the point we're trying to make is like, at some point.
You can.
At some
you
point,
can,
your
but there's
body's
there's hidden spots like this that you cannot.
Right. I guess at certain at a certain time, like your body.
Your limitations.
Has going to have more limitations.
Yes, correct. You are what you can, what you're limited to.
Yeah.
And so we seen his limitations, and it was, you know, we go back and we get our camera equipment, and I realized that they left.
Or not even age. Like it could be anything else. Like,
but I realized they left.
Health related or whatever.
But I realized they left, and I thought like, fuck, like that, this is beautiful. They didn't get to see it.
Yeah. And or it could be health related. It could be that, you know, you have other issues that you're not able to travel anymore. And I think for the moment when like, for me, whenever we are able to travel, we are able to do this, I feel like, you know, it's a privilege to be able to like be taking these trips and be doing this, because, you know, if I was working a regular 9-to-5 or you were working a regular 9-to-5, like it'd be harder. We'd have to kind of be scheduling in between this and that. And, you know, so I think there's a lot to like appreciate.
Yeah. Even if you do work 9-to-5.
Yeah.
You can still appreciate this. You know what I mean?
Right.
But like I said, there are limitations, right? If you work 9-to-5. You're limited to whatever certain you can do periods. Afterwards.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But.
So anyway,
I think we're,
both of us.
I think we're both kind of like, you know, trying to, yeah. Well, let's just
I think
say,
we're going to take a moment and just sit here and watch.
Yeah.
Oh, you hear that wind? Ah, oh, my God. Okay.
That's my favorite, is like when we can just like share like a little bit of the sound. Like over there, we share the silence. Over here, we share the wind.
The trees, the birds, the wind. Okay, so I think
we're getting cursi.
Yeah, we are. We're going down that path like, we love you guys. Kumbaya. We're getting there. So we need to stop. We need to wrap this up. Like I said, we're going to sit here for a little bit. I hope you enjoy this view. I hope you really take it in as much as we have. We'll try to show you as much as possible as we can.
If you guys have a recommendation of like somewhere that you think we should film at.
Where you think we should film, but where you like it.
As we're thinking about like, you know, future travels, if you have a place that you would recommend, let us know. Because we are always like interested in learning more about cool places to see and cool places to visit that we haven't been to before.
Yeah.
But with that, I will say, say, if you enjoyed this episode, share it with a friend.
Yes, correct. What? We're trying to like, bye. No, but if you like this episode, you like the view, and you think to yourself, you know who would enjoy that? My mom. My mom would enjoy that view. Share this video with her. Tell her, let her know that New Mexico's out here like this, man. Or your sister, maybe your crazy cousin, or, you know, or just your batshit cousin. Invite them out here. We talk nonsense. We talk craziness. We share a little bit of our life and a little bit of our expertise. And yeah.
And if you wouldn't mind, if you would give us a rating or a review on Apple Podcasts, that Correct. Would be great, because that helps us to find new listeners for new listeners mm-hmm. to find us, and just to keep growing this community that we're building of you know, people that like listening
it's
to us.
It's not
banter.
Our community. It's your community. This right. community is your community. We just happen to be a part of it.
Yeah.
And we would like to join others, ask others to join us along this community. So like, share, support, comment. That's the way you can do it. Give some stars, a little rating. The more people that rate us and review us, the more actual listeners we could potentially find to be part of the community also.
Yeah, and with that,
we'll see you next time.
All right, thank you guys.
Bye.